This tutorial is about image-based lighting in Maya. I've got a scene open here in Maya, just a room with no ceiling. Step one is to go to my render settings. So I'll click this button here, render settings will open up, and I need to make sure that mental ray is turned on. Image-based lighting is a feature of mental ray. It won't work without mental ray. And then to find image-based lighting, we go to the indirect lighting tab, and image-based lighting is the first option. I'll just hit create to create a new IBL node, and a couple things happen. First, we get this yellow sphere in the background, and the image-based lighting node opens up in our attribute editor on the side here. And then we just plug our texture in by clicking on the folder next to image name, and we point it at whatever image we want to use for our lighting. And we'll see that this yellow sphere is something that I can manipulate in the world. So in this case, I'm rotating it so that I can have the sunlight come in through my windows. Now for a point of reference, here's my original render. Now we're going to compare it to the image-based lighting we've just turned on. When my new render does pop up, I can see that it looks different, it looks a bit brighter, but it still doesn't look quite correct. So what's going on here? We need to go back into our render settings, and under the Common tab, that first tab on the left, we need to scroll all the way to the bottom and find our render options. We need to turn off Use Default Light. Otherwise, Maya is going to render that on top of our image-based lighting. And when I do re-render my scene, I see that my scene is very, very dark. We're not actually getting a lot of image-based lighting. All the lighting we saw before was from the default light. We want to fix that. We'll see that there is an Emit Light button on our IBL node. We need to turn that on so that it actually creates light. Duh, right? And when I re-render, we'll see the lighting is very different. We actually get lighting now instead of just having the black environment. But we could use a little bit more lighting. Now, one thing that we can do is go into the render settings, go to the indirect lighting tab, and turn on final gathering. That'll add a little bit of light, but we still need a little bit more. So we're going to create a new light, a key light, and that's going to be a directional light. So create lights, directional. And that directional light is going to act as my sun, as my main light source. And in this fashion, we can add a lot of light to the scene very quickly. So I'll scale the directional light up in the viewport just to make it easier to work with. And then I'll rotate it around so that it is pointing in the same direction that the sun's rays would be. I'll recolor the light so that it's slightly orange so that it matches the sun. I can sample pixels from the image to get a good match. And then I want to make sure that shadow casting is on. This key light is a quick and easy way to add primary shadows to my scene. And when I re-render, no big surprises, we do get more light in the scene, but let's step it up. I'm going to turn the ceiling on in my scene, and so that's going to close off a lot of the light that's coming in from the sky. And when we re-render, we'll see that our scene is very different. It's almost entirely black. So what happened here? It's very, very different. From a ray tracing perspective, all the rays that are being cast from the image-based lighting sphere are having a hard time getting in through those windows. We've closed off a lot of areas that those rays can travel through. So what can we do to fix this? So we could try playing around with our render settings, but the answer is not in there. We need to get more light in through the windows. So I'm going to create a new light, an area light. So create lights, area light. And then I'm going to rotate it and move it and rescale it so that that area light basically covers up all of the windows on the side of the room. And now I have to go into the attributes of that light and look for the mental ray tab. And under the mental ray tab, there's an area light tab. I need to turn it on so that it uses the light's shape, and I'm going to make it visible. And then I need to scroll down. This is the important part. All the way at the bottom, there is a light shader slot. I want to click to add something to that. And when my node window pops up, I'm looking for mental ray lights, and I want to add a Maya portal light. So how does the portal light solve our problems? Well, it's specifically designed for the situation we're in. It takes the area light, it basically looks behind it, says what's going on in the environment, and then the area light projects that in front of itself. In this case, that's exactly what we need. We've got a room that's too dark because we can't shoot enough rays from our ray tracing in there. So portal light should solve that, but we'll see that when we re-render, it doesn't. And that's because in this case, the default parameters don't work. I'm going to increase the multiplier on my portal light. And after that adjustment, when I re-render, I get something that looks a lot more correct. We have a lot more light in the room. There are some things we have to tweak. For example, the ceiling is a little bit too bright and the far side of the room is a little bit too dark. And these are both easy fixes. The first, I'll just tilt my area light down a little bit and we'll see that that darkens the ceiling. And for the far side, I'll just add a new area light. I'll position it so that it fills the windows. In the attributes, I'll make sure that I'm using the shape. I'll attach a portal node. And now we see the far side of the room is just a little bit brighter. It feels a little bit more correct for the lighting setup that we have. In the previous renders, we do get a lot of grain. So to resolve that, I went to the Quality tab in the Render Settings window and just dragged the Quality slider up to create this render. And as a final touch, I add light fog using a party volume, and that's it. I'm James Taylor. Subscribe to my channel or go to methodj.com for more. Thanks for watching.